Morning, students. So today we will continue the topic that is probability. Yesterday we have done up to question number 5. Today we will start with the question number 6. So in question number 6, refer to table 14.7, chapter 14. That means this question you have to take from chapter number 14. I just sent the picture of this question in the group. You have to find the probability of the students obtained less than 20% in the mathematics test. Find the probability that a student obtained mark 60 or above. This is the table of 14.7. In this you have given a survey of 90 students. Those who have marks 0 to 20% are 7, 20 to 30% are 10, 30 to 40% are 10, 40 to 50% are 20, 50 to 60% are 20, 60 to 70% are 15, and 70 above 8. So total students are 90. So in this case, we have a total number of cases are 90. That is total number of students. Now we will do the solution of this question. So solution is here. This is the table. Now total number of student of in a class that are 90. In first case, you have to find number of student who get less than 20% marks. So this is the first range, 0 to 20. 0 to 20 means you have to see the number start from 0 and up to 19. Not 20 will include in this interval. 20 included in the next interval. So lower limit is always included the interval. Upper limit is not including in that particular interval. So 0 to 20 means we have see the number of student whose percentage is 0%, 1%, 2%, 3%, 4%, 5%, 6%, 7%, 8%, 9%, 10%, 11%, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19%. 19% is your last point. So number of students are 7. So probability less than 20%, that means favorable cases divided by total number of cases. Favorable cases are 7, total number of cases are 90. So answer is 7 upon 90. In second case, you have to find the number of student whose marks is more than 60% or above. More than 60%, that means you will consider these two interval, 60 to 70 and 70 above, because 70 above is also in the interval of 60 to 70, because he said you have to find above 60%. Above 60% means 70%, 80%, 85%, 90%, any number. So we will add these two numbers, add these two frequencies. So number of student getting 60% or above marks, that is 15 plus 8, this is equal to 23. So probability of 60 or above favorable cases divided by total number of cases. Favorable cases are 23, total number of cases are 90. So answer is 23 upon 90. So this is the solution of question number 6. Now see question number 7. In question number 7, to know the option of the student about the marks statistics, a survey of 200 students was conducted. The data is recorded in the following table. So in this question, you have to find the probability on the subject of statistics having surveyed having 200 students. So likes means those students who like stats having 135 students. Those students does not like stats, they are 65. You have to find the probability in first case like statistic, in second case does not like it. Now we will do the solution of this question. Now see, total number of students you have given 200, number of students who like statistics, they are 135. So probability like statistics, favorable cases divided by total number of cases. Favorable cases are 135, total number of cases are 200. Just substitute the value and you will get your answer. In second part, you have to find the number of student who does not like statistics. So first, total number of cases, that is total number of students are 200. Number of student who does not like statistics, they are 65. So probability does not like statistic, favorable cases divided by total number of cases. So they are 65 upon 200. Cutting on the table of 5, you will get your answer. Very simple question. Now see question number 8. In question number 8, refer to question number 2, exercise 14.2. What is the empirical probability that an engineer lives less than 7 km from her workplace? more than 7 km from her workplace within half kilometer from the from her place of work. That means you have to find the answer of three questions. First is those workers whose distance from his workplace is 7 km. Second, you have to find those workers whose distance is more than or equal to 7 km. And third is you have to find the number of workers whose distance is within half kilometer. So you have in this question, you have given one data. I will show that data. This one is the actual statement of question number 8. You have said that 40 engineers from her residence to their place of work are given. So you have to find the number of students who number of workers whose distance is 7 km less, number of workers whose distance is more than or equal to 7 km or within half kilometer. So first you have to find the number of workers whose distance is less than 7 km. So this is in less than 7, this is less than 7, this is less than 7, less than 7, less than 7, less than 7, 7, less than 7. So total are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. One more is there, this one 9. So number of cases, favorable cases are 9, total are 40. So this is equal to 9 upon 40. Second part, you have to find the more than 7, or that means rest of the distance are more than 7. So total are 40. If 9 are less than 7, then 31 are more than 7. So favorable cases are 31. Within half kilometer, no value is having half is there. So favorable cases are 0. Now see the solution of this question. Total number of student, total number of female workers are 40. Number of engineer whose residence is less than 7 km from her from their place of work, that are 9. So probability of less than 7 km from her workplace, that is favorable cases, divided by total number of cases. Favorable cases are 9, total number of cases are 40. In second part, you have to find more than. So this is the case of more than. Number of engineer whose residence is more than equal to 7 km from her workplace, they are 31. So probability more than or equal to 7 km, that is favorable cases, divided by total number of cases. Favorable cases are 31. Total cases are same, that are 40. So 31 upon 40. So number of engineer whose residence is within half kilometer from her workplace, there is a no cases there. So favorable cases are 0. So probability within half kilometer is favorable cases, divided by total number of cases. 0 divided by 40, this is equal to 0. This is a complete solution of question number 8. Question number 9 and 10 are both her activities. So leave these question. After that, write down question number 11. In question number 11, 11 bags of wheat flour, each marked 5 kg, actually contain the following weights of flour: 4.97, 5.05, 5.08, 5.03, 5.5, 5.06, 5.08, 4.98, 5.04, 5.07 and 5. Find the probability that these of the bags chosen at random contain more than 5 kg of flour. That means you have to choose that bags whose weight is more than 5 kg. So first, second, third, four, five, 6, 7. So that means there are total 7 cases whose weight is more than 7. Total number of cases are 11. So probability is 7 upon 11. Now see the solution of this question. This is the solution. Total number of wheat bag are 11. Number of flour, wheat flour bags which contain more than 5 kg flour, they are 7. So probability more than 5 kg, this is equal to favorable cases, divided by total number of cases. Favorable cases are 7, total number of cases are 11. So this is the solution of question number 11. Question number 12. In question number 5, exercise 14.2, you were asked to prepare a frequency distribution table regarding the concentration of sulfur dioxide in the air part per millions of certain city for the 30 days. Using this table, find the probability of concentration of sulfur dioxide in the interval of 0 to 12 to 0 to 0.16 on any of these days. That means you have to given the data in question number 5 of exercise 14.2. You have to prepare a frequency distribution table. This how to make frequency distribution table, you very well aware about it, but you have to start with like 0.12 to 0.16. that is 4 number difference you have to take, 0.04 difference you have to take when you are making the table. First I will show the question. So this is the statement of question number 12. Here you have given the data, you have to prepare a frequency distribution table first for this question. After that you have to choose one particular interval, this one, 0.12 to 0.16, for finding the probability in this interval. So you know how to make the interval. First start with, now see, this is the frequency distribution table. Concentration of sulfur dioxide in ppm, start with the least value 0.00 to 0.04. in this interval you will see the value of 0.001, 0.00, 0.002, 0.003, not including 0.004. so total cases are 4. Similarly, 4 to 8 are 9, 8 to 12 are 9, 12 to 16 are 2, 16 to 20 are 4, 20 to 24 are 2. So you have to find the interval, you have to find the probability in this interval. So number of favorable cases are 2, total number of cases are 30. So probability is 2 upon 30. See, total number of observation are 30. Number of observation in between the interval of 0.12 to 0.16 are 2. So probability of 0.12 to 0.16, favorable cases divided by total number of cases, favorable cases are 2, total number of cases are 30. So answer is 1 upon 15. So this is the solution of question number 12. Now see the statement of question number 13. In question number 1, exercise 14.2, you were asked to prepare a frequency distribution table regarding the blood group of the 30 students of a class. Use this table to determine the probability that is a student of this class selected at random has blood group AB. That means you have to find the number of student whose blood group is AB. You have to find the probability of number of student whose blood group is AB. So first I will show the actual statement of this question. So this is a statement. The blood group of 30 students of the class 8th are recorded as, these are the 30 student blood group. Use this table to determine the probability that a student this class selected at random has blood group AB. So first you will prepare a frequency distribution table. So how to prepare a frequency distribution table? That there is a no need to prepare. Now you have to check how many students have a blood group AB. 1, 2, 3. So there are total 3 students whose blood group is 3 AB. So there are 3 favorable cases are there. Now see the solution of this question. Total number of students in a class are 30. Number of students whose blood group is AB, that are 3. Probability has blood group AB. This is equal to favorable cases divided by total number of cases. Favorable cases are 3. Total number of cases are 30. So after cutting, you will get your answer. This is the last question of your exercise. Your chapter is finished. So go through all the question and listen again if you have any doubt in any question.